Welcome to Issues in Japan. The topic this time is: if Lee Jae-myung is the next president, Japan-Korea relations will be at their worst. I would like to share the insights of Mr. Masatoshi Mutoh, former ambassador extraordinary and plenipotentiary to the Republic of Korea. This is part 2. In addition to these statements, Lee Jae-myung has repeatedly stated that the current Republic of Korea was created by pro-Japanese forces in collaboration with the U.S. occupation forces, that the pro-Japanese residue has not been completely cleared up, and that the U.S. forces that placed the area south of the 38th parallel under military rule after Japan's defeat are in occupying forces. The U.S. entered the area south of the 38th parallel after the end of World War II. However, this was not with the intention of occupying Korea, but to promote Korean independence based on the Potsdam Declaration. The U.S. subsequently made great sacrifices to protect South Korea from North Korean aggression and Chinese military intervention, and even after the Korean War, it played a leading role in protecting South Korea's security from North Korea's repeated provocations. Does Mr. Lee Jae-myung recognize that South Korea is where it is today thanks to the U.S. military? He has not condemned the Soviet Union for its tacit approval of North Korea's invasion, or China for its intervention in the Korean War. Yet, it seems as if he wants to say that it was a mistake that South Korea was protected by the U.S. military and developed into one of the top 10 economies in the world in terms of GDP, and that it would have been better to join North Korea and become a part of the unipolar rule of the Workers' Party of Korea. It is astonishing that Lee Jae-myung would make such a statement that denies the very existence of the South Korean nation. His remarks give the impression that the post-war history of South Korea itself was a mistake. Furthermore, Mr. Lee Jae-myung repeatedly asks, if Japan, the aggressor nation, had to be divided, why did Korea, the victim nation, have to be divided? There is no denying that such a view exists in the minds of Koreans, but for a presidential candidate to make such a statement publicly calls into question his insight. In an interview published by the Jeonhung Ilbo newspaper on July 23, Lee Jae-myung said, Japan's hardline stance is due to the Japanese militarist forces' intention to invade. Why does Japan repeatedly make Dokdo, Takashima's Korean name, an issue? Isn't it to use Dokdo as a tripwire when they advance to the continent one day? I, Lee Jae-myung, am of the opinion that Japan's dream of advancing to the continent should be handled in the event that it erupts in a military manner. Militarily, the North is an important opponent, but we should not relax our vigilance against Japan either. Mr. Lee Jae-myung made similar remarks at a meeting of the Foreign Correspondents Club on November 25. At a meeting of the Foreign Correspondents Club on November 25, he made similar remarks, even now, they are dreaming of becoming a military power, and they are constantly provoking Dokdo, Takashima, Shimane Prefecture, which South Korea effectively controls, by claiming it as their territory. It does not seem that they have clearly acknowledged their past history and sincerely regretted it. It seems that in Lee Jae-myung's mind, Japan is still engraved as a nation that aspires to become a military power. He seems to have no appreciation for the fact that Japan has maintained a peaceful constitution since World War II and renews its vow of non-war every year on August 15. That's probably why he also expressed his natural opposition to the formation of a military alliance between Japan, the U.S. and South Korea. On the other hand, Mr. Lee Jae-myung has said that he wants to restore Japan-Korea relations on the model of the Obuchi Kim Dae-jung Declaration. This is a statement that makes one wonder if he really understands the contents of the Japan-Korea Joint Declaration. The Japan-Korea Joint Declaration, which promoted cultural exchange between Japan and South Korea and contributed to the subsequent friendly atmosphere between the two countries, was signed in 1998 by then Prime Minister Keizo Obuchi and then President Kim Dae-jung. At that time, President Kim Dae-jung visited Japan and delivered a speech at the plenary session of the House of Councilors. After the Second World War, Japan changed. The Japanese people have shed their sweat and tears, and with the development of parliamentary democracy, Japan has achieved economic growth that has astounded the world. For the first time in human history, the Japanese people experienced the devastation of the atomic bombing, but they have always adhered to the principles of the peace constitution and non-nuclear pacifism. I would like to express my deepest respect for the bloody efforts of the Japanese people and their leaders in the post-war period. On the other hand, Lee Jae-myung's view of Japan is that Japan is still a militaristic nation just as it was before World War II. With this view, there is no way that a restoration of relations modeled on the Obuchi Kim Dae-jung Declaration can be achieved. Doesn't Mr. Lee understand this? Mr. Lee Jae-myung continues to criticize the right-wing political circles in Japan. At a roundtable discussion at the Foreign Correspondents Club, he expressed the need for caution, saying, "If you look at what the political forces with real authority are thinking in terms of concrete ideas, there are times when the desire to advance to the continent, which invaded South Korea, momentarily hovers in the background at certain times." The term right-wing political circles was used by the Jomong Ilbo, which reported this statement, but it probably refers to the Liberal Democratic Party, LDP, government, not the so-called far-right forces. Lee Jae-myung's hostility toward the Liberal Democratic Party, LDP, and its politicians seems to be quite strong in his heart. On the other hand, Lee Jae-myung's recent remarks include, "I love the Japanese people and have great respect for their humility, sincerity, and politeness." Is he trying to say that he loves the Japanese people because they are good people, while the authorities and politicians in Japan still have ambitions to invade other countries? Or is it just a social courtesy to the Japanese people? In Korea, there is a term called conscientious Japanese, which refers to former Japanese who are naturalized citizens of Korea and who say that Takashima is Korean territory. In any case, Mr. Lee Jae-myung's understanding of modern Japan is completely off the mark. Regarding his own political style, Lee Jae-myung said at a roundtable meeting of the Foreign Correspondents Club, "My firm position is to adhere to a pragmatic diplomatic line that goes beyond the logic of principles and choices and focuses on the national interest." However, in his speech when he won the inter-party primaries to select a presidential candidate for the Democratic Party of Korea, he said, "We won a perfect victory in a short period of time against Japan's retaliation against our exports, and we will overtake Japan, catch up with developed countries, and eventually create a country that will lead the world, the Republic of Korea." With regard to Japan's tightening of export controls, the idea that the ROK overcame the crisis by producing strategic goods domestically when it was cornered is merely a performance statement made by President Moon Jae-in to the public. It is true that South Korea has begun to produce substitutes for items that would have been more cost-effective to import from Japan, but it continues to import high-quality items from Japan. They are not at a point where they can say they have completely overcome the problem. Is he confident in Korea's domestic production and R&D capabilities based on a statement by the current president that does not reflect such a situation? If so, it is hard to believe that this is a pragmatic diplomatic path centered on the national interest. Judging from Lee Jae-myung's statements to date, even those that sound future-oriented are actually based on the premise of Japan's apology, and Lee's opinions on Takashima and conscripted workers are absolutely unacceptable to the Japanese government. If Lee Jae-myung, who is steeped in hostility and rivalry toward Japan in the areas of diplomacy and the economy, becomes president, Japan-Korea relations, which are currently at an all-time low, will become even more strained. So far, the insights of Mr. Masatoshi Mutoh, former ambassador extraordinary and plenipotentiary to the Republic of Korea. Thank you for watching.